Welcome to Engineering with Rosie. Today I want to talk about how wind turbine designers take care of a really important issue. How do they make sure the blades don't hit the tower? I'm going to talk about how to choose whether to put the blades upwind or downwind of the tower, and then some other things that you can do to keep the blades well out of the way of the tower, including rotor tilt and overhang, cone angle, and then something that I think is a particularly clever design solution, pre-bending the blades away from the tower. Okay, so I think it is pretty obvious why it's important to make sure that wind turbine blades don't hit the tower. But maybe it's not so obvious why that is even something that you need to worry about. Wind turbine blades are usually pretty flexible. They can easily bend like 10 or even 20% of their length when they're under very strong winds. Of course, you could just make them stiffer, but to do that, you would need to add a lot of material, which costs money and makes the blades heavy. It means that every other part of the turbine needs to be strengthened to carry the heavier blades. There's also some advantages with flexible blades that the extreme wind loads aren't as high on a flexible blade as a really stiff one. So designers want to make the blade strong enough to withstand the strong wind loads, but still a bit flexible. So the next most obvious question is, why don't we just put the blades on the downwind side of the tower? Then when the wind blows on the blades, it will bend them away from the tower. So in that case, it wouldn't matter how stiff they are. And actually there are turbines like this, such as this little two-bladed turbine that I visited recently. So behind me we have a small wind turbine which is sold for farm or home usage. This one is connected to a household of 5 people and it creates more than enough electricity for that house, and the excess is sold to the grid. So there are a few really interesting design features about this turbine, and obviously you can see it only has 2 blades whereas most large modern turbines have 3. But the one I want to talk about today is the fact that the blades are located downwind. You can see from the direction my hair is blowing that the wind is coming from behind me, and the blades on this turbine, they're actually located on the downwind side of the tower. And the advantage of putting them on the downwind side is that if there's a strong gust of wind, then the direction that the blades are going to bend is away from the tower. So you know it's never going to hit the tower. So that solution works really well for that small turbine that we just saw, but modern utility scale turbines pretty much all have their blades on the upwind side of the tower. Why? Why are wind turbine blade structural designers making their job harder than it needs to be? So to answer that question, let's take a trip to a wind turbine test site to have a look at some modern turbines and find out why designers want to put the blades upwind, and then what steps they take to make sure that even though the blades are upwind, they never bend and hit the tower. Remember when we saw the small two-bladed turbine, we talked about how its blades were on the downwind side of the tower so that they wouldn't bend and hit the tower in strong wind. Well, there's a lot of other reasons why it's better to, or more efficient to, have the blades on the upwind side of the tower, and nearly all modern industrial turbines are made in this way. So what are the reasons that make it better or more efficient to have the blades on the upwind side of the tower instead of the downwind? The first issue is that if the blades are downwind of the tower, then the tower is blocking wind from hitting the blade when it's directly behind it. Now, that might not sound like a very big problem. I mean, the tower is pretty skinny. It only covers a pretty small portion of the area that the blades sweep. Can that make such a difference? The problem isn't so much that there's a loss of power production from that blocked wind, it's more that when the blade is behind the tower in its shadow, so to speak, then the blade, it won't bend as much as when it's out of the shadow in the wind. So every time the blade passes the tower, it goes from bending away to the tower to suddenly bending towards it when it goes past, and then back away from it again when it's out of the shadow. Now this is bad for the blade structure because all of the times that the blade bends over its lifetime, they add up and they can eventually break the blade. This is called fatigue loading. It's the same effect as when you bend a paperclip back and forth. Each individual bend may not be enough to damage it, but after enough bends, the paperclip or the blade will break. So wind turbine blade designers are very concerned to reduce the fatigue loading on a blade. locating the blades downwind of the tower. It also causes an audible thump every time the blade passes the tower, which is no doubt really annoying for anybody who has to listen to it. Okay, so those are pretty compelling reasons to locate the blades upwind of the tower. You wouldn't want to have the blade's lifetime reduced due to fatigue loading from the constant bending in the tower shadow, but you also wouldn't want it to break because it smashed into the tower. So if we can't just make the blades stiff enough that they don't bend at all, then how do wind turbine engineers make sure the blades won't hit the tower? There are a few things that they do. First, the hub that the blades are attached to, it's sticking out away from the tower and the end of this big box, which is called the nacelle. Obviously, the further the overhang, the more the blades can bend before they hit the tower. But a really big overhang increases bending moments on the shaft and the nacelle bed plate, which complicates the design of these components. So you don't want to make the overhang too big. Second, you can tilt the rotor disc away from the tower to increase clearance that way. Of course, the more you tilt, the less area of wind your blades are sweeping, which reduces the amount of power available to the turbine. So you need to keep the tilt angle small, but angles of around 5 or 6 degrees give extra blade tower clearance with only a very small reduction in power. Third, you can change the cone angle. The blades on a wind turbine, they aren't mounted strictly in plane to sweep a flat disc. They're angled slightly away to make like a very shallow cone shape. So the more that you angle them out, obviously the more clearance that you get between the blade and the tower. But once again, the bigger the angle, the smaller your swept area becomes. So cone angles are usually kept small, maybe around 2 or 3 degrees. And the final method that wind turbine designers use to make sure that the blades don't hit the tower is my personal favorite. I think it's a really clever design solution, so I want to show you. I found some good examples of this back at the test center, so let's go back there now to see. Now I'm next to some blades which are sitting on the ground, and you can see one really interesting feature about them. The tips, they're bent away from the ground. So to avoid the problem of blades hitting the tower in strong winds, they pre-bend them so that the tips start out bent away from the tower, and then when the wind blows, they have some extra distance to go before they would hit the tower. So that's the options for how wind turbine designers can keep the blades from hitting the tower. I like the pre-bend option the best because it doesn't cause much penalty in aerodynamic efficiency or structural design challenges as the other options do. Though it is more challenging to manufacture and transport the blades like this. So are these the only option that turbine designers have to stop blades hitting towers? Well, actually, in some of the more modern turbines, they can monitor the position of the blades in real time. And if the blade is going to get too close to the tower, then they can change the blade angle so it moves away as it passes the tower and then back to its normal position once it's passed. This means that blades can be more flexible and potentially lighter, which helps with other aspects of the turbine design. But it makes the control system more complicated, and of course it needs to be really reliable because the consequences of getting it wrong could be very serious. If you were designing a wind turbine, how would you make sure the blades don't hit the tower? Using one of the methods I've talked about here, or have you got a totally different idea? Please tell me in the comments. And also feel free to ask for more explanation on anything I've talked about in this video or to suggest another topic. Remember that if you want to see more videos like this, then you should like and subscribe and share with your friends. I'll see you next time.